there was a sense of need, a sense of being doing something worthwhile. We had a job to do, and we were very happy to do it. I started flying in 1939. I have flown 27 types of military aircraft during World War II and after. And then I've flown nearly 30 different types of civilian aircraft. My name is Iris Cummings Critchell.
I'm 94 and a half, and I have a current pilot certificate and a current flight instructor rating.
I was encouraged to do some swimming in a pool about the age of 11 or 12. After winning the national championship, I'm on the track toward the Olympic tryouts. Berlin had been chosen 8 years before, long before Hitler came to power. When we go over to the track and field stadium, and there was a section that we could sit in. It wasn't very far from Hitler's box, and we saw whenever he came and went. After my event was over, that was that. I was all eyes to what else I could see and learn about. At 18, I flew 8 hours and just about ready to soar at this flight school. Well, by the time I went to college in 37, graduated in 41, I had elected to major in physics and math. So I was very excited all through the years at USC about the idea of the flying and that what I was studying was preparing me. And it was only a matter of 2 or 3 months before it was clear that that's where I belonged when Pearl Harbor occurred and I could help. In September 1942, the U.S. military made its decision to try out having women pilots. And they became what we call the original WAFS, Women's Auxiliary Ferrying Squadron. After the war, there was a great need for more teaching. During the war, I had met Critch, and at the end of our service, when I was sent home, Critch and I were married, and then I flew with the Civil Air Patrol and did instructing. But I think many students have blossomed forth on their own.
That has been the key to what has made it such a rewarding experience. So I say the importance is to be prepared and then lucky to be at the right place at the right time.